Well, good afternoon and welcome again to another exciting edition of the Bobcat Banner. Dr. Phillips here back in my office getting ready to do some work. Actually, it's in the afternoon. I'm about done with my work. I'm ready to go on home. I got a couple projects I think we'll do around here first before I do that. I got a cool new basketball gizmo that we have delivered to school, and then I'm going to work on my walls. I have my little baseball bat. Some of you may have known of those. If you've been into my office, you know, my little collection, I have bases on my wall now. I can't see them because they're on the other side of the screen. And I'm going to make a little ballpark on my wall to be able to store my bat. So that's going to be a cool project I've got coming up here. So how about you? What kind of cool projects have you been working on? And you've been doing, have a little bit of different time. I wanted to say free time because it's really been kind of different, hasn't it? All things that we're doing. Well, let's get to our events of the day. So first of all, let's go through EduKits. Now, some of these links are going to be on the, should be in the banner on the paper itself. But EduKits, those have been around a little while, know is a company that puts together all of the school supplies that you need. Everything that is on the supply list is in an EduKit box. I've enjoyed the last couple of years. I put check. Matter of fact, I've already ordered mine for my son Wesley for next year. You click a button, you pay the price, and for at parent teacher orientation, being the school year, we're going to give that to you. You'll have everything. You don't have to go out and shop for any of your school supplies. It's all in there. I will say though that the calculated prices are the type of calculator that we want, but they're a little expensive. You can find those separately for a lot better price than the ones they're going to do for you there. But the other things, just the papers and pencils and things, are all listed in there. So it's a pretty good deal if you like the convenience of that. If you don't, fine. Some people like back to school shopping with their kids. If you want to do it that way, you're welcome to do that. I know there's a good number of families that did partake in that last year. However, Vacation Stations is a summer review. In it, there are workbook pages, two per day, that help kind of keep focused in your academic skills. And some of those may be kind of necessary if you are kind of visualizing your your child and the work that they're going through. You may think, you know what, you may need to do a little bit more. It's not a lot. It's not exhaustive. Take 15, 20 minutes a day, I think. Make sure they're reading and doing some other kind of fun activities. And so the kindergarten, first grade through sixth grade, that's available for you. If you like to do that, let school know. We'll order those and get those to you right away. So the information should be in there as well. And then lastly, you can kind of see this picture of our lost and found table. Mrs. Wegman did a wonderful job of getting it all set up and nice and neat for you. So you need to come out. So you can come to check out your clean out your child's locker or the book or come in to pick something off. Why don't you stop by the table, see if there's something on there that belongs to you. Probably not to you, but to your children that may have been left here. So please come and take what certainly does belong to you. All right. Now, Otis has not been around to deliver these awards for the people from last week. We'll get a bunny up there too soon. That was a little soon. Bunny, go back. But we do want to congratulate the Charles family and the Hinsey family for their spring training baseball pitchers that they took. We showed those last year. And Otis is going to get around. I hear he's in the building. Perhaps we'll see him later in the broadcast, even today. All right, so here are the pet pitchers. They're kind of fun. First of all, we've got the Anderson's Bunny playing the Wii or PlayStation or whatever bunnies play. After nibbling on some Fritos chips, then we have the Nep Kitties that are there sitting on top of their homework papers. Then Rose, nope, not Rosemary yet. This is Marissa. And Marissa has her cuddly dog all curled up in there. Looks like they're both kind of nice and cuddled up in there. This is Rosemary. Rosemary has a hedgehog. And the hedgehog looks just getting ready to take care of that homework paper there, huh? And then we go to the Bingham's household. The Bingham's apparently don't have a dog, so Dad has to act like the dog. And so that's a cool thing that's got a saddle and everything. They didn't have those when I was, my kids were younger. They just had to ride bareback and everything that we did. And then we have Addie. Addie is Chloe's sister. She's apparently a moose. At least that's what it kind of looks like, kind of moose-like. So that's her pet there. And then we have the Probelski's kids. They don't have pets. They used to have them, and now they have the ones that don't make a mess, and they just sit there pleasantly and politely as you do their homework. Then we had Naomi. Naomi put a nice little scrunchie in her pet's hair, and Caden's dog curled up there. It looks like he's kind of taking over the entire floor. When Caden is finishing up his homework, and then Max, Cat apparently wants some Captain Crunch with him, and so he's trying to nibble there, and then Max tries to keep it away from him. But here we have our two winners for this, and they will be receiving prizes. We've got a prize envelope for everybody who are the winners each week, and so the Bobcat winners this week, first of all, goes to Wally. Wally has chickens. I don't know how pet-like chickens are. They're delicious, but I'm not sure as far as pets-like they are. But there they are, and they're even so competent chickens, almost like Foghorn Leghorn, those of you who are old enough to remember him, helping him with his homework. And in that case, Wally is certainly more intelligent than Foghorn Leghorn was. And then the coolest one obviously has to be Jackson and his guitar sunglass wearing dog. So I don't know who's going to be more talented there, whether it's Jackson or the dog. That's a good picture there. And we appreciate everybody bringing them in for us so that we can see them. All right, then let's do our spirit activity for next week. Next week is what we're going to do. We're going to record your child telling their favorite joke. Have them dress up. A little clue here, makes you pause for the punchline, not too long, and we don't want it to be long, just a quick joke, pause, punchline, and only one per recording, so one per person, per family. If you send those in, so pick your favorite joke that you may have, and make sure those recordings get turned in by next Wednesday, and we'll play some of those, and we'll have them all set for us for next week. All right, again, as we're plugging along, things are going well. I hear something out in the hallway. Let me pause for a second. We'll go in the hallway and check out to see what's going on out there, okay? So hang tight. Okay, well, here we are. I came out to the cafeteria area. I thought I heard something, so I kind of came out. And so, hey, Otis, I thought I heard something out there. What are you doing here? Okay, all right, you playing, taking cat naps? All right, yes, very good. Okay, all right, so let's see, what is going on? Oh, you got something to say? All right. Oh, you want to get in on the jokes. Oh, I get it. You got a joke. Okay, so what's a cat's favorite color? What is a cat's favorite color? Boys and girls, what do you think? Cat's favorite color, that is purple, of course. That's funny, Botus. All right, purple. All right. Now, so, oh, you got another one? All right, let's see, what does this one say? It says, what do cats eat for breakfast? What do cats eat for breakfast? I don't know, eggs and ham and bacon? They could eat bacon, couldn't they? Mice Krispies. Oh, Otis, that's funny. That's funny. That's good stuff, Otis. All right, hey, kids, you do the same thing. Now, you tell us your favorite jokes for next week, and we're looking forward to having them. We'll play them again next week in our video Bobcat Banner. So have a great weekend. We'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.